You've been told in the past that you lose control of your personal data when you use free services like Facebook, Google, or Instagram. I'm here to tell you that that's a big, fat lie. Nowadays, most of us pay for products and services that assume ownership of our data. That new car you bought? Yeah, it's collecting data about your driving habits and sending it to the car manufacturer or insurance company. That Alexa device you purchased to use in your home? Well, it's uploading every word you say to Amazon's servers. The Ring camera system, your smart TV, your robot vacuum, your mobile phone. Control of your data is no longer determined by whether or not you pay for a product or service. It's now determined by who cares about it the most. And I want you to care about who controls your data, because guess what? You've got more power than you realize to take back that ownership of what is rightfully yours. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh. My goal here is to clearly explain how your personal information ends up outside of your control and what you can do about the data that's already out there. And if you stick with me to the end of this video, all right, I'm gonna give you three very specific changes that you can make to keep your private information private going forward. This video is being sponsored by Delete Me, which is one of the tools that I use and recommend to remove my personal information online. There's a link and a discount code in the description, but more on that in a moment. For now, let's answer this very deceptively difficult question. How did we get to this point where the internet is literally littered with all of our personal information? The road that has led us to this dystopian data society was paved with what I believe are mostly good intentions. Smart speakers, smart TVs, wearables, and other such devices were designed to make our lives easier. Now, it's easy to point fingers at big tech companies like Google and Amazon, who I admit love to collect our data, but there are really four different ways that our data gets released. Voluntary exposure, obligatory disclosure, data scraping, and activity tracking. Voluntary exposure is basically the stuff that you share online without anybody forcing you to do so. So that photo that you just posted on Instagram for the world to see, or that dating profile that you filled out, that Facebook group that you joined, all of that is voluntary exposure. And don't hear me wrong, I'm not saying that all of this is bad. You just need to understand how much control you give up by how much you publicly share voluntarily. It's not about deleting your social media or going off the grid. It's simply about being aware of how much you're sharing and how that could affect you down the road. That public photo of you and your kid or you and your grandkid, it really just paints this big fat target on your back that scammers can use to socially manipulate you. Now, aside from limiting how much you share, the best thing you can do, and you've probably heard me say this many times before, is to just make sure that all your social media is private. I mean, if you have public profiles up elsewhere, for example, on LinkedIn, some dating site, or another website, make sure that you only share what is absolutely necessary. Now, there are so many times in our lives where we are forced to give over information that we would rather not give out. Perhaps you want to use this cool new budgeting app, but in order to do so, you're forced to connect your bank via Plaid. Who's Plaid? And you have no option but to share account names, account numbers, and a bunch of other information. Maybe you're filling out some kind of application that asks for all sorts of random information that for some reason they think is required. Or, and this one frustrates me, you get asked to put in your email address so that a business can email you a receipt and save the planet. Yeah, right. So there are two things I want to point out here. First, what I've learned over the many years of dealing with this stuff is often what's listed as required isn't actually required. Don't be afraid to say no to people, even in person, or to at least ask politely why such information would be required. When you start doing this, you might be surprised at how many times the reply will just be a simple, okay, thanks. I mean, if it's absolutely necessary, they won't let you proceed without providing the info, but often you're just asked for more than it's needed. Second, because we want to have control over our own data, when we give it over to somebody else, we're having to trust that they're going to take good care of it. And if you listen to the Surveillance Report podcast and all the new breaches that they share each and every week, you'll know that even the biggest companies can't take care of your data. So what's the solution? Well, first, you need to be very careful about who you trust. but we also need to learn how to mask the information that we're required to give out. Now, in past videos, I've talked about how to mask your home address, your phone number, your credit card number. And I'm gonna leave links to each of these videos below, so I'm not gonna go into detail about each of those here. But the next two ways that we lose control of our data are a little more insidious. The first is data scraping. Now, your data can be scraped from so many different places, but you can usually thank your local government for most of this one. We're talking real estate records, driving records, criminal records, immigration records. All of these are public records, often published by your government, and there are plenty of services online that are more than happy to scrape that information and create a profile on you without your knowledge or even your consent. It's alarming just how easy it is for me to do research on somebody that I'm about to meet, and I can get a pretty good idea of their income level, their property value, or any criminal record that they might have. Now, sure, you could spend the time and money to put your house into a trust or to hire an online reputation consultant, but for most people, at least those in the United States, I recommend having a service like Delete Me make legal data removal requests from all of these scraping services. Just over the past 10 months, they've removed my name, address, phone, property records, occupation, and so much more from 35 different data brokers that were selling that online. I mean, it gives me great peace of mind knowing that they're constantly monitoring the internet for my personal information and then aggressively following up with removal notices to these data brokers. As you move toward a greater awareness of your online security, why not take advantage of their offer to give you 20% off when you use the code ATS at checkout? I mean, you'll probably be shocked at how much of your data Delete Me will not only find, but then be able to remove online. Finally, after the data that you voluntarily give over, that you're obliged to give over, and the data that is scraped on you, one final way that our data gets exposed without our knowledge is activity tracking. If you use Chrome, even in incognito mode, your browsing activity is being tracked. Every purchase you make online is being tracked. Your phone GPS is being tracked by various apps. Now, often we give consent to this kind of tracking without really realizing it, but a lot of times it happens whether we agree to it or not, and that can be somewhat frightening. Okay, you've made it this far in the video, so I wanna make sure you have some practical action items that you can take away. I promised you three of them at the top of this video, so here they are. First, I recommend that you set aside 10 minutes today to walk through the privacy settings on your phone. For both Android and iOS, you'll find that in the settings under privacy. So which apps get to see your GPS location? I mean, always or just while you're using it? What about Bluetooth? Or the camera and the microphone, unless you can give me a good reason why they need that data, you should probably remove the app's right to access it. Second, find ways to monitor your data. You can pay for a monitoring service like Delete Me, which I've already talked about, but if you refuse to spend the money, you can also set Google alerts to find when your name, address, or phone number pop up online. You never know where it will appear, and at least if you're aware of it, you can make that request to have them take it down. Finally, I recommend you take steps to reduce your digital footprint. This means deleting apps or programs that you don't use anymore, closing down accounts that you don't log into, and switching to more privacy-focused options for things like email, internet browsing, cloud storage, and so much more. If this is something that you're interested to learn more about, I'm creating more and more video content addressing these issues that you can watch right here. So go ahead and click right here.